Hello students, I am Dushyant here and today we are in a conversation with my friend Saurabh, who cleared this time's Indian Forest Services exam with an exceptional 16th rank. So first of all, I want to congratulate my friend for that achievement.
Thank you.
In this conversation, we are going to discuss about his journey, his achievement, and the kind of information which we can get through him regarding the coaching institutes which are around. This will be a very informal kind of conversation, so as to understand the reality, what all he faced during his own preparation. So Saurabh, first tell us about your background.
Yeah. Hi all, this is Saurabh and I belong to Samastipur, Bihar. I have done my schooling from the same Samastipur district. After that, I have done BTech from Cochin University, Kerala. I am a naval architect by profession. In 2010, I graduated and I worked for 6 years, 3 years in India and 3 years in UAE. After that, in 16, I left job to prepare for the civil services and the forest services. In this duration, I gave 2 civil services mains and 1 forest service mains. This was my first forest service mains. I got good marks and hence rank 16. And one thing I would like to add, that my schooling was in Hindi medium till class 10th, and forest service exams is conducted only in English medium. So I crossed that barrier of Hindi English, and I would like to advise that all the students who have Hindi medium can also do forest services.
Okay. See, the situation is, we get to know about this, that forest services prelims is difficult as compared to that of civils, because we have to get a higher cutoff for that. So can you share with us what was your strategy regarding the prelims?
First of all, I would like to highlight that only hard work or only smart work cannot get you success in this particular exam. You have to have a combination of both, at least in 99% of the cases. And when I say hard work, it means at least 8 to 10 hours per day for a continuous of 2 years. And when I say smart work, so you have to be adaptive of the changes as well as understand the requirements of UPSC. This particular requirement many a times are artificially distorted by profit making coachings. So you should not get into the trap of coachings. You should believe yourself, and UPSC previous question papers will be a best guide for you. So first of all, hard work, smart work. Then coming next, I would like to highlight the importance of one single source. So one single source should be done for each topic rather than doing 2 sources for a single topic, because the syllabus consists almost all the subjects, even your science, humanities, mathematics plays a role in CSAT. We have geography, we have economy, we have almost everything under the sun. So you cannot cover everything comprehensively. You have to be a master of, you have not to be a master of all, you have to know everything and common sense.
Okay, so can you tell us, as you were saying, that the coaching is not that required, and I heard this thing as well, that you never took the coaching, formal coaching, for at least for GS.
Yeah, I did not take coaching for GS. Like the fashion is, you come to Delhi and you start a coaching for all the subjects, GS 1, 2, 3, 4, you pay a hefty amount of 1.5 lakhs, and after that, many students leave the coaching in between because they are not able to manage the time and self-study. So rather than that, I did everything on my own, and in case things required, I did specific 1 or 2 modules at some places.
Okay, so if you are suggesting this idea that one can start preparing without the help of the coachings as well, can you give us any idea about the kind of sources one needs to follow while preparing for the prelims, please?
Yes, sure. I would like to highlight that you have to make a first preliminary list. Preliminary list in the sense that, yes, these are the must. For example, I would say that first we breathe, and then we take water, and then we need food, then we need shelter, and then we go for the luxuries of life. Same is with the UPSC syllabus preparation. You have to first think what is needed for brief. That is what the preliminary source is. And in this one, I had divided the prelims in 8 parts. I would like to recommend sources for each one. For example, history. So history, I would say for modern, you can refer Spectrum. For ancient medieval, one can refer Tamil Nadu and trust himself. He will do good. In case somebody wants to do more, he can go for old NCRTs of R.S. Sarma and Satish Chandra also. Regarding culture, you have to do 11th NCRT and chapter 1, 2, 5 and 6 from Nitin Singhania, which are a bit scoring topics. Then Jainism and Buddhism has been a favorite topic of UPSC since last 5-6 years. So for that, you can invest enough time in A.L. Basam book, The Wonder India Was, only the chapter on Jainism and Buddhism. So that was about history. Regarding geography, you can do NCRTs of class 11. In case you have any doubt, you can refer the Murnal geography videos on that particular topic. But NCRTs have to be by heart. Recently, they are not asking more questions on physical geography, but they can change the trend anytime. Since from recent trends, we have to do mapping. I used learning space mapping videos for the same, and sir was very good in this. Polity, Lakshmikant, you should not make mistakes from the questions in Lakshmikant. Questions made mistake in polity will throw you out of the competition. Economy, I used Crux of Indian Economy as my basic sources, and some of the Murnal old videos were available, that one I used. Now Murnal is uploading the videos, you can refer the same. And Crux of Indian Economy is highly recommended for the international organization chapters. Regarding environment, you can do it from PMFIS or Shankar IS. Shankar IS goes a bit bulky, so you can refer PMFIS and the chapters which are not there in PMFIS, like international organization in environment, that you can do from Shankar. Regarding science and tech, any one thing basic needs to be done. The topics are PSLV, GSLV, warships, submarines, then your anti-tank missiles, your ballistic missiles. These things you can even Google, because they are selected limited topics, and prepare your notes on them. You have to top up the same with the current affair. It should not be that you do only current affair and you don't do basis. Regarding current affair overall, I would say any one source. If you are doing newspaper full year, that is well enough. And you can supplement with the one compilation which is available before examination. Regarding test and questions, I would like to recommend that 2011 to 18, they have 800 question papers. Those 800 question papers are 800 indications of to you that UPSC has already given since the change of the pattern. So 800 indications have already been given, and still you are believing on some coaching which prepares the test papers in haste. They have to prepare 3000, 4000 question papers. Somebody, students like me and you, prepare that. So rather than believing on their intellect, you have to believe on UPSC intellect. After that is done, you have to go for any one test series of any one coaching, but that 5 to 10 tests should be given at center, because the temperament development of examination, how you are going to mark OMR, how you are going to fill the sheet, and how you are going to proceed in the examination, that should be done beforehand. So that's what is there for
play. Okay, that's a very good insight. We have got the complete list of for each and every subject. So at least this can help you a lot in while you are preparing by yourself. But then the market is flooded with a lot of current affairs as of present. Will you recommend a kind of current affairs that is monthly compilation or a complete year compilation is much more beneficial for students?
Yes. The idea should be that the material should suit to your preparation cycle. Not your preparation cycle should change as per material. What is happening that every day 3-4 hours are being given to current affairs, and then again in examination what is being asked, people are not able to recall. That is a blunder. Whatever you are doing, you have to keep a knack of that, and you should be able to revise. Suppose you are investing 10 hours in some particular material in December and you are not able to revise, you are not going to answer the same material. So if it suits the monthly one, I would like to make it clear that there are few materials in market monthly. they have not utility in full utility in prelims and no full utility in mains. They have items common to prelims as well as mains. Then what happens when prelims is on your head some 15 days before, you cannot revise something which is there for mains. You have to do only for prelims. So in that one, confusion arises. So I would like to recommend that year-wise compilations are also good, especially for the initial attempters who have a lot to cover into the syllabus.
Now from this, we can make this out that at least sorting is required to understand your own strengths and weaknesses first, and then to go for that kind of material which is required. Okay, then there is a question among the students regarding the test series, because when we go into the market, there are number of test series which are available. Like you are also saying, we should go into some test series and give that in the
simulated
environment itself. So which test series will you recommend to the students?
That's what I was thinking, that what I did in last attempt, that I gave 2-3 test series and several papers. So rather than believing on the intellect of a particular coaching, I averaged the effect by giving 4-5 test series papers, and I was always ready to give a test whenever in newspaper or I will get a message, a GS open mock is there for prelims, I'll go. It just takes 2 hours and 3 or 4 hours of analysis. So you should be ready to give the test anytime. There are free tests of one each available. And also you can take like one thing, I like the GS score tests were conducted in school last time. So it gave an environment, a feeling of to you that you get ready into the morning, you go to the examination center and papers are distributed. So some sort of simulation is given. So that you can do, they are giving this year also. And besides, and it is being done in almost many of the cities. Other than that, you can make a group of people and you can write tests on your own. You can see every day should be a better XYZ than the previous day. You have to learn from the day, you have to learn from the test.
Okay, so that's a very good info, that joining a formal test series is not required here. What you can do is that you can manage it by going to the open mock test of the different coaching centers. Because this will not only help you to put your eggs in different baskets, but will also save your money, which is very hard and preciously earned. So that's a very good info for the students like us. Then moving to the next level of preparation, and that is the mains. Okay, when we talk about mains, there is a question among the students that do we require to prepare separately for prelims and separately for mains?
See, you have to break down and understand the syllabus in 3 terms. One is the things which are there only for pre, one which are there common for pre and mains, and one which are there only for mains. So pre and common to pre and mains should be or must be done before prelims. Common to exclusive to mains can be done after pre or before pre, depending on your comfort. And answer writing must be done one round before prelims, and if you can do and must be done after prelims also.
Okay, so in mains, you are saying that it should be according to the requirement of the person.
Yes.
But before the prelims itself, one should try and write the answers. Also for the mains.
There is a logic behind that. When we write answers for mains, then we realized how it should be studied. So it's an iterative process. Sometimes we study and then we realize, okay, how should we write? And sometimes we write, then we realize how should we study. So it's an iterative process to and fro.
Okay. So again, for mains also, there is again a question regarding the test series. Because a lot of institutes are running on the basis of this test series. Are these test series so important?
Test series are important. Test series must be given in the simulated environment of 3 hours practice. But I would like to highlight that mainly students are giving tests between prelims and mains. And in that particular period, the test series becomes a business. Because the market is flooded with the students who are writing mains, and there are not good quality checkers at that time, so you get compromised quality. That is why in 2017 I joined a test series full-fledged one, but in 18 I left that test. I did not join any test series formally for all the subjects. I gave it on same piecemeal basis, like some coaching is giving 4-5 tests in some money, I went and gave. Then again to the other one. Besides that, I would like to highlight that rather than relying on the intellect of coaching or a particular person checker, you have to rely on intellect of yours. That yes, how I have to make my answer better. Is everyone doing diagrams? Or is everyone doing the points in bullet format, paragraph format, or what? How my paper is appearing to the checker? How toppers have been written? Toppers answer sheets are available online and you can refer them to refine your answer. It has to be a daily basis activity. When you join test series, you do modifications or improvement once in a week. Rather than that, your improvement should be on a daily basis.
Okay. So yeah, that's a very good insight that it's a very continuous process of answer writing. A problem with a lot of students is regarding the answer writing rather than being the knowledge issue. So we understand that point. Now coming to the next stage of this exam, and that stage is the interview part. Interview part for most of the students is very difficult because we always keep on preparing for prelims and mains. We are not having a lot of focus on the interview part. Like we have questions regarding hobbies, questions regarding your background. So what all challenges you faced while you were preparing for your interview?
See, regarding interview, what Dushyant highlighted, I would like to add one thing, that interview preparation is nothing new. You write in depth what you are. You have to be honest. Why? Because they have almost 100 or 150 years of cumulative professional experience. If you are lying, they can catch you. Suppose you are writing a hobby. My hobby was Sudoku. So when I write the hobby which I myself believe or which is my real hobby, I don't need to prepare much. So in that way, I would like to say that yes, interview preparation is more because it's not the checking of information. You check UPSC notification. It is saying that your knowledge has already been tested in mains. But I myself did not answer many questions of the chairman, but I got 190 out of 300 in interview, which is a very good marks. So what I would say that rather than walking upon facts, you have to understand the psychology that you don't have to break. An All India Service officer should not buckle upon the pressures. Okay. Or if you don't know, it's okay to say, sorry, sir. Every particular question is a new ball and you have to play like a good batsman.
Okay. Yeah, that's a very important thing to understand that while we are in the interviews, we should not be bothered about the last question. The better thing to do is to be bothered about the next question and thinking about the next question.
In fact, I would like to add that this is true for all prelims, means everything, because in prelims also sometimes you are not able to do a particular question, the hangover comes to the next question and next question. Suppose I will give a situation in which you could not answer 10 questions on a stretch. What will happen? 11th question, your intellect may fail, but that is what is being tested. You do not have to break. That 10 questions are not making the difference. 11th question, which is easy one, that is making the difference. The same comes with the story of mains and same comes with the story of interview.
Okay. But still, some students have this doubt in their mind that if you are not answering into the interview, then it is having a negative effect. Can, for those students' sake, can you tell us few questions which you are not knowing? And as we know, he got 190 marks out of 300. So it's a good score. So if he tells us about some few questions which he never knew, this will give us an indication that not knowing even some questions is also all right. It's not a big problem. Yes. So few of the questions.
When I entered the room, I was asked, okay, Saurabh, you have worked for workbench building. So you have gone to seas. I said, yes. So what is the first thing you will see when you have steering? So this question can be specific. I had never taken steering into my hand. and there can be many things which can be seen. I tried it with three guests. I tried it once, twice, thrice, but I was not able to answer. So see my what my first impression was. Then he asked, okay, what is Malacca Strait? I told. Why is Malacca Strait important? I told. Then he asked, what is the width of Malacca Strait? I said, sorry, sir. How much is the distance of Andaman Nicobar from Malacca Strait? I said, sorry. How much is the distance of Andaman Nicobar from mainland? I said, sorry, sir, I don't know the exact number. Can I take a guess? He said, no. See, the normal mentality will be there in that particular situation. Your first 5 minutes of interview, you are not able to answer properly. And added on to that, he passed on to the next member and he asked a small question. And then he asked, tell us, speak 1 minute on Arthashastra. I mean, before me, there were 5-6 days and interview over and I was almost the last, so more than 200 had given and I could not see this thing in anyone's transcript. So had I buckled at that moment, I would not have got 190. But after that, I retracted and I gave answers to all members and then it came back to chairman again. Chairman, first question, I was not able to answer well, but second question again, I answered well. So you can see that live. In fact, when I came out of the interview board, I was worried. I told Dushyant also, I don't think things went as per me because I had prepared so much. But I told him one thing that, see, Dushyant, they asked me many questions, but I did not buckle. See, that was one satisfaction to me, but I did not know how much I'll get. But I got 190. Then I can say that knowing a fact is not a compulsory thing. If you know, good. If you don't know, then also good. Just keep your temperament high.
That's very important to understand that all these are the methods of stress testing. And if you are not buckling down in the condition of that stress, that's what they need to test. So these factual questions are regarding that stress testing around you. Now, this was all about the interview. Now, that was all the serious part of the talk. Now, we should move to the lighter part of it. So, how is life after clearing the exam and getting 6th rank All India? So, it must have been great.
Yes, I would like to highlight that I had a few interactions with bureaucracy and that motivated me to come into the services. After coming into the preparation, I never thought that getting into power or getting some sort of this sort of achievement will be some beneficial for that. I was just aiming for the service. But after results were declared, I got very overwhelmed by the responses of my family, friends, and in my hometown. So that came as an added surprise for me. And it has been all awesome for me last 1 month.
That's great. By this journey of so as well, that it's never too late. For if you want to start something new in your life, if you have determination in your heart and that firm belief in your mind, you can achieve anything. Okay, like we have heard this thing that you left your job after 4 years of doing that job. And
I did 6 years of job.
Okay.
And when I thought of leaving job, I was already 28. So taking that particular risk at that particular moment, I was discouraged by many. But equally, I was encouraged by one of my friend Ashish, and that's how I could leave the job and try for the services. And now I'm satisfied because I didn't, even I have not got the service, then I was satisfied that yes, I came and I tried what I wanted. Getting or not getting is not important. Trying honestly is the best important thing.
Yeah, very, very, very great to know that. And again, on a very lighter note, because after this life, you have achieved the exam, the success in the exam. Now, the next question is very light-hearted question, that when are you getting married after this?
Maybe after foundation course.
We hope and we pray for the great future of Saurabh. That was the conversation and a very informative conversation with Saurabh. So as to tell you that preparation of UPSC never requires you to go for those expensive coachings. That can also be achieved by your determination, by your planning, and by following the process daily. So that's it for today. Thank you. Thanks a lot.